We all know opioids have become a huge problem in our country, and overdose deaths are largely related to synthetic opioids like fentanyl. But you might not know that opioid use is occurring in your patient population. Many people who use opioids don't even know that they are, because fentanyl is often found in powder drugs like cocaine and pressed into counterfeit pills sold as stimulants or benzodiazepines. Pediatricians and other pediatric professionals can incorporate screening into regular checkups using the familiar Ask, Counsel, Treat, known as ACT approach, to start a conversation and offer help. As a pediatrician, I firmly believe that I have the power to support my patients' health and well-being. And I know that adolescents who disclose opioid use can benefit from the treatment. But where to start? Ask. I use screening tools and respectful, accurate language that avoids stigma and treats both those with and without substance use disorders with dignity. I rely on the validated screening tools because they help catch substance use I might miss in a clinical impression alone. Screening tools can help determine the level of risk, from abstinence to higher risk for a substance use disorder. Abstinence means they never use drugs or more than a few sips of alcohol. Substance use with low risk for a disorder means they have used substances but haven't developed significant problems related to their use. Mild to moderate risk for a substance use disorder means they use more frequently or use in high-risk situations, such as while driving or when they're alone. They may have a history of problems at home or school, or used to relieve stress. High risk for a substance use disorder means they've experienced loss of control or use compulsively with significant problems related to their substance use. When I have time alone with my patients, I assure them that my questions are a routine part of what I ask everyone and that they are not being singled out. I explain that unless they are in danger, our conversation is private. For example, I start by asking if the patient has any private questions or concerns to discuss with me. I thank the patient for completing any screening tools. I follow up on reports of substance use by first appreciating their honesty and asking them to tell me more about their use, including understand why they use, how often, and any problems they have experienced. I also provide encouragement when patients are not using or have made positive changes around their use. When I have a patient who confides in me and discloses substance use, I offer support and empathy. If I identify risk, I'll say something like, "I appreciate you sharing all of that. It sounds like you use substances for certain reasons, but also have experienced some problems related to their use. I do have concerns about your health. So could we discuss some ways that might improve your health and maybe decrease some harms of substance use?" I move on to counsel during the visit by providing education and guidance on substance use, including harm reduction and overdose prevention. When potential opioid exposure is identified, I talk to the patient and their family about naloxone and fentanyl test strips to help with overdose prevention. And when treatment is warranted, I offer options for medications for opioid use disorder, answer questions, and address their concerns. I have local and national resources on hand to share with patients and family. And I explain that with these treatments and resources, I am here to accompany them as they achieve their recovery goals. Youth opioid use and overdose remain a critical concern in our country. Not only do young people get opioids from legitimate prescriptions, but opioids can be found in a variety of counterfeit pills and powder drugs. And other substance use often occurs before young people use opioids. Pediatricians are at the forefront of the opioid crisis and have the power to make a difference. They can ask about opioid and other substance use, they can counsel on ways to decrease harms, and they can provide treatment, including medications for opioid use disorder, overdose prevention tools, and connection to resources. Pediatricians can save lives.